the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own.
Meeting your season goal comes with higher rewards.
They get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claim me, you my dog? Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four door Audi. When it smoke, they get the high to make them scary boys run. Remember when I...
Today.
And they'll begin by running the option.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big play there out of the running game.
That may be a sneak peek on this opening drive of what this young rookie can showcase, his legs.
And normally, as you start a game, you're just thinking, can he get the snap? Can he hand off? Can he just execute? Instead, he doesn't waste any time on wrapping another dimension to his game, showing off those wheels and picking up some nice yardage.
Well, there you go, Charles, the first completed pass of his young career.
And we expect it not to be his last. Very good to get the first one out of the way, though, as he begins his career.
Henry on first down, not finding much running room as he pushes forward for a yard or two at most. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Back to throw. Open man is Fitzpatrick. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Under pressure, and he'll go down. Sacked back at the 31. First down carry for Henry. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. A gain of three, second down. He'll drop to throw. And the pressure will bring him down here. The Cardinals get home for the sack. Chandler Jones. It'll go as a loss of about eight as he gets in there to drop him.
Well, that's the second time he's been sacked so far in the first half. And if they have designs on having a big year, on going anywhere.
Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. Here's the option. He'll have a first down inside the 10, and he'll be out of bounds. Now, after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Boy, not what you want to see in quarter one of the new year. We'll be back. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Henry will score. Touchdown, Tennessee. Throwing here on first down. He completes it to Julio Jones. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A nice throw right there. And these fans getting their first look at their QB1 of the future. And I'd imagine it's got to be a big plus for him to get his first start here in front of that home crowd.
I know there's a school of thought about getting your first start away from home so you don't have the extra pressure of that crowd behind you. But I say ride the wave. Embrace it. Go ahead and play to that level, and I think it's going to benefit him in the long run.
Here's second and eight. Can't get away, and he's taken down. Chandler Jones able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. The Cards going nickel. An extra defensive back out there now on third down. They'll look to throw here. And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete. They'll start out here with the option left. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
So, CD, big changes for 2021. Of course, last year we had the expansion from 6 to 7 teams in each conference making the playoffs. This year, the headline, the addition of a 17th regular season game. What did you think when you heard the news that this was happening?
Well, my first thought, partner, was finally, because we've heard about a 17th game coming for a long time, and now here it is. So the beautiful part about all of it, is that 17th game is going to be like these interdivision, interconference type games that are going to match up and play out over a four-year period. And that's kind of cool. And I was looking forward to seeing some of the matchups that were going to come out of that for that 17th game. And could that be the game that decides a bunch of division titles?
It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Something to watch here in week 1 of the season, tackling. Because you and I both know that in the preseason, a lot of these guys don't play a whole lot. Plus, the intensity and the speed really ratchets up on opening week.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Well, he is certainly dangerous when he spots a lane, and he keeps it himself there and worked out well.
And how about the moving parts on a play like this? You know you have to practice it over and over because it's almost like a ballet that has to be choreographed. But how about once he made the decision to go, he committed to it and went. Let's face it, most teams are going to defend the running back much more than the quarterback on that type of a play.
And they'll try the option on 1st and goal.
And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. A great play there with his first. They'll start on the ground. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll power ahead, but only for about 3 yards. 2nd down coming up. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They'll look to throw. Throw left side here, hauled in by the tight end, Ferkser. Another completion there, and we think back to the draft in the spring. This franchise essentially handing him the keys to the operation, a top 5 pick. Charles, how ready do you think he is?
I think he's ready for the NFL in terms of size, speed, the makeup of him, the character of him. The key's going to be, will this team accept everything he brings to the game and adapt to it, not just necessarily plug him into something that he doesn't do well.
Play action fake. They'll look to throw. That's taken in by Ferkser. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Another completion there. And what a big moment in a young quarterback's life, that first NFL start. And Charles, obviously they want him to win games, but if they're looking at him under a microscope in this first month or so, what do you think they're hoping to see from him?
Well, for every question they'll have for him, they should have for themselves as a coaching staff, because it's not just how quickly can he learn the offense, it's what they can teach him, right? How can he build a relationship with his receivers? And, of course, how open is he to learning? And, of course, how open are they to giving him things that he can put in place on the field?
Buying time to his left. And he'll slide to a halt here, still a little shy of the first down marker. He'll wind up getting 4 there on his own, but it will leave him now with a 3rd down situation.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold it for a short gain when it took off running.
A nice completion there for the 1st down. And, Charles, you think about the quarterbacks of recent vintage that have been thrust into action week 1. It's no guarantee of future success, but we sure have seen some good ones.
We certainly have, partner. How about Joe Burrow with the Bengals in 2020? He was excellent. Kyler Murray with the Cardinals. The best part about his game, has his team run the brink of the playoffs. And Deshaun Watson has won division titles after having started from day one. Remember, the Titans lost Jonnu Smith, their number 1 tight end, the last few years when he signed with New England in free agency. So that might open up a few more looks for Ferkser, and he makes a smooth catch there.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. It is intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Nickell Rwby Coleman. And the Cardinals are...
They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Man open here is Jones. And they're able to get this one across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. On play action, they'll throw. Caught on the right side by Jones. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45.
That's a pretty throw right there. That ball's in the air a long time, but it's right on the money on the right sideline. A really good route. Moving the defenders towards the middle of the field before breaking to the sideline. What a completion there. Big time arm strength. Very nice route.
That went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. He was trying to get it to A.J. Brown that time, and that'll bring up second down. Forced out to his left. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. A big play there on the scramble. Some early fireworks from this rookie quarterback getting the start in week one.
And every time a rookie quarterback gets to start week one, you and I both know the extra attention that comes with it. We know that he's going to throw the football, but will he make the right decisions? And in this case, with his legs, he showed the defense there's an extra dynamic to his game.
Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown. Anthony Furtzer has the first half. Begin with Henry. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. That catch good for 5. It's third down. They'll try and pick it up by running the option to the right. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. I'll tell you, there is no antidote for speed, even at the quarterback position, as he keeps it himself and turns it into good yardage.
And it still takes time for a defender to react, even as quarterbacks carry the ball more and more in today's NFL. They're still a little bit in disbelief and realize, oh my goodness,
touchdown Titans! Derrick Henry, already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. The drive will start with an option going left. He'll have a first down past the... Oh, he breaks a tackle, and he's got an alley. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big pickup there on the run. He was able to escape the pocket and get out of bounds. You like the decision-making?
I love the decision-making, and I love the execution, because you just know that his eyes were darting all over the place. Now they talk about keeping your head on a swivel, looking for the danger spots, where the hits are going to come from. How about him getting all he could out of that run and then getting out of bounds?
And he told us, look, I'm a rookie. I'm waiting for the game to slow down, but it seems like he's processing things pretty well.
He certainly is. He's slowing the game down himself with his actions.
They'll set up to throw. Jones has it. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a 2-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try to put the hammer down and finish this one off.
And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
trying to punch it in with Henry. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. They'll start out here with the option left. Into the secondary, past the 40. And finally brought down at the 38. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Oh, hate to see this. Week one of the season. We'll be back. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. On first down, it's Henry. And oh, he sheds a tackle. Now he's got some space. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Quick slant to Brown. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A nice throw there. We've seen a lot of those from this young man. How would you assess, Charles, his first start thus far?
I think it's been everything that they could have asked for because he's handled all the basic things quite well. And even some of the wrinkles that have been thrown at him, he's shown a lot of poise throughout and made some nice plays.
Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down. They'll set up a throw. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. The sack there by J.J. Watt. The Titans on third down. They've converted four times out of six. Not bad. This is third and 17. That'll be caught by Brown. Touchdown, Tennessee. A.J. Brown there to make the grab. And the Titans are looking good here this season. Start with an option going left. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
But that's the fear any defense has when the quarterback gets involved in the running game. You don't usually account for him, and he's hurting them today.
Yeah, he's been very involved in the running game. Defensively, when you've got the coverage good downfield, how do you account for him, though?
Occasionally, you start to spy him. Take someone who has the same agility, who can dance with him, run with him, and try and keep him in the pocket.
Yeah, it'll be especially critical here as we come down the stretch in the fourth. Yeah, he's able to push his way forward somehow for a gain of about 2 yards. Second down now. Off the option, here's Henry. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. The Titans on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This is third and 7. They're going to look to throw. The cards get to him here. He's brought down for a sack. Chandler Jones picks up his second. Start by running the option to the right. And he's going to be brought down inside the 45 at the 43. Now a timeout being called as there's an injured Titan down on the field. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. He'll decide to keep this once more. And he got blown up. Losing yardage on the play back at the 44. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that's going to lead to a 3rd and 4 coming up. He'll look to throw. And that one goes incomplete on the drop. That's one he definitely normally catches. And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he's able to get this inside the 10 now to the 9. He'll pick up 7 there on the first down keeper.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with a lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get 4 downs on first down. They did that plus 3.
So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a 3rd down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. This is caught. Touchdown! Nick Westbrook-Ikhine. A 14-yard touchdown. Well, a little drama there at the end, but really this thing was already decided. The late points get scored, and then it ends on the kickoff.
And I'm right there with you, partner. At the end of the game, they knew what they had to do. Just make sure you don't cough up the football at the end. Just take care of it, and victory was theirs, and that's exactly what they did.
So for Tennessee, that'll be a happy locker room as they start the season 1-0. And they will hit the road next week to take on the...
Today.
They'll start by running the option to the right. And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. They'll drop the throw. He's going deep for Brown. And a high throw there as this is knocked away down to the ground and incomplete. And the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. Looking to throw. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Carlos Dunlap. At the 33, following a good pickup of 8. The numbers on the ground for Henry last week. The hat trick plus 1, 4 trips to the end zone with his legs.
And partner, you know how all the guys do when they do that little symbol now about eating, right? Keep feeding me, feeding me. They just kept feeding him and feeding him, and next thing you know, he kept getting in the end zone.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. They'll run on first down. Henry. And he'll take this ahead for about 4. Second down coming up. Coming up on a 2nd and 6. Well, this defense for the Seahawks, terrific last week in the season opening victory.
But we certainly had a nice conversation with the defensive coordinator, didn't we? And what we heard, I like what we did. But we definitely need more pressure on the quarterback this week.
And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down. He'll look to throw. Steps away to his left. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Alton Robinson. Throw now in his own end zone. He's got his tight end, Anthony Firkser, and he takes this just about a yard shy of the 20.
A nice throw right there. And Charles, this is game number 2 in the NFL for this young rookie. His guys getting the victory last week, and he played pretty well by most accounts. Curious, what did you see?
I saw something similar to what you described, Brandon, because I saw a guy who looked the part, a guy who was in command. Not just with the touchdown passes, but definitely look to be in control of the offense as well. And you and I both know that's often uncommon for a rookie quarterback.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. A shotgun handoff to Henry. And this is going to be a Titans first down as he gets this up past the 30 to the 32. And now hang tight here, following the play, still down on the ground, is A.J. Brown. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Back to throw now on first down. That's complete to his tight end, Firkser. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. And just a yard to go here on second down. Now back to throw. That's caught. Nick Westbrook-Ikhine with it. And he is down deep into Seattle territory. A big play that time for the Titans.
This offense has been slow to get started, but that play will certainly give them a little bit of life. Maybe the late wake-up call that they had been seeking.
Back to the ground now. It's Henry. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And he'll go down. Brought down at the 20-yard line. Call it a loss of 5. A big sack to bring up 3rd down. to throw here. Flushed out right. And they work this near the five. He'll be stopped at the six.
These type of plays are backbreakers for our defense. They thought they had him hemmed in, thought they were going to get him on the ground with the pass rush, but were unable to do so. He gets away, picks up a big first down, and sets up.
And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. A great effort there. Start the drive. And that'll be caught by Dez Fitzpatrick. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of five.
5 yards remain on second down. And he's going to use his legs here.
And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That second down play nets a minus four. The Titans on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third and 8. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. A 50-50 ball here, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Darquez Denard, and they will set up shop.
Down. It's Henry.
And he's upended at the 33 following a good pickup of 8.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs. Run some plays, run some clock. Allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score. That was a round run, not just with dexterity, but with intelligence. Found the hole in the zone, made sure the quarterback saw him, and was able to make the sure catch and put the down marker back to 1.
They run the option here on 1st and 10.
And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Give him 3 on the keeper there, and it is 2nd down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
Bobby Wagner, multiple times an All-Pro, in there to drop him for a loss.
The Titans on 3rd down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 8. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's going to air one out.
And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
To throw.
And that's complete to Westbrook Akine.
A gain of 6 there on 1st.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's 3rd down.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a 1st down.
Normally on 3rd down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field, and a nice dart picks up the 1st down and then some.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw.
Gets this to Ferkser, the tight end.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now Tennessee going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. They'll look to throw again. Flush to his right. He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone, and it is incomplete. Good positioning there downfield to break that one up. Back to throw again. And that is incomplete. Nearly intercepted. The free safety couldn't quite get his hands around it, and it brings up third down.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back end. Pass rush, they've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync, only way to play good defense.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
They'll throw now on the final play. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Play fake here on first down. He's got the tight end Furtzer, right side complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They'll go option to the short side. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Give him 4 yards there on the first down keeper. Second and 6. Open man, Westbrook Akine. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. To throw and taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. And that went a little too high as it's knocked away and incomplete.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived, it wasn't a surprise, and he was able to bat it away.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. Just what Seattle was hoping for. The coverage holds, and now...
Thank you.
They'll run on first down. Henry. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Nice satisfying run on first down for the offense, picking up 5, which means defensively, the thought process is entirely different. You don't want to panic, but at the same time, you're saying to each other, we've got to tighten this down. We can't give up gains like that.
2nd and 5. Guys, man, that's the Pro Bowler Julio Jones. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled.
Well, I can put my defensive cap on right now, and I know they're saying don't give up any big plays now. They've controlled this game throughout, and all they want to do is see it through to the end. I think they let their guard down a little bit with that last completion. Sometimes when you're trying not to give up bigger plays, you don't react as fast as you should on other throws. As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on it?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Yeah, the rookie's going to learn as he goes. Here's a 2nd and 7. Eluding the pressure right. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24.
But to me, this leads to the question, do you admire the way he puts his body out there all the time, or do you think he should protect himself a little bit more?
Well, he's been on the ground several times with all those sacks that he's taken. So I don't know. I kind of admire him not sliding down there, don't you?
I'm with you on that one. The meter definitely leans towards admiration.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. He's going to have the hook up to Izzo. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11.
While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. 10th carry now for Derrick Henry. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
48 yards rushing for him now to this point.
From the 5, 2nd and 4. Again, it's Henry. And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Derrick Henry, his 5th touchdown now on the year. Throwing here on first down. Being chased out left. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Normally we're talking about a quarterback duel where they're matching each other pass for pass. How about the footwork in this with both of these guys running the ball well?
Yeah, they mixed in the run game. You're exactly right. Now, both coaches might not like how much their quarterbacks have taken off, but another example right there of just good mobility.
And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. They'll look to throw. This complete to Jones. And that'll wind up moving the chains again as the tackle's going to be made at the Seahawks' 13-yard line.
From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10.
Now that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Well, he had success earlier in the drive keeping it himself. Not here, though.
And sometimes when you have that kind of success, you can fall in love with the option a little bit too much and not give the defense credit for making adjustments themselves. And that play starts to lose its effectiveness.
Now we're going to get a timeout here as it looks like there's a Seahawk injured on the play. The run hasn't worked the last couple of plays. Now it's 3rd and 14. We'll check on his status when we get back. Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. Toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And able to catch it, but he's out of bounds. And the throw took him beyond the sideline, and that's going to be a turnover. First down, he'll drop to throw it. Flushed out right. Throws right side, and that's complete. Now they got to get to the line quickly. They go play action here on first down. He's going to wind up and air it out. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's 3rd down.
This has been a rough one, to put it mildly for him, and after this one's done, you just feel like in the post-game press conference, this team's going to have a lot of questions and definitely not a lot of answers.
He's caught on the sideline, but he's not going to have a first down. They say he was out of bounds, so a big call there that brings up 4th. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. That's taken in by Ferkser. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And now here comes their final timeout as they take it with 8 ticks remaining. Play fake. He'll look to throw. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And this ball incomplete. Looked very much to be a catchable ball and could not hang on. 2nd down coming up. 2nd and 10 now from the 27. One final shot. They'll look to throw. Looking for the end zone. And it'll be intercepted. Picked off by DJ Reed. And the Seahawks are going to take possession of the football. So the victory here for Seattle. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big...
Walking down the dark road, hardcore. just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claiming you my dog and then you hold on me? Nowadays they ain't showing real loyalty. I was walking down the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These four pockets full won't fold on me. How you claiming you my dog and then you hold on me? Nowadays they ain't showing real loyalty. I was walking down the dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't
just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on up.
Today.
This is Derrick Henry. The numbers on the ground for Henry last week. 12 carries and even 60 yards and a touchdown.
And well-liked by his teammates. In fact, I got on good authority, even though I'm not an investigative reporter, that in their team meeting this week, the offensive line stood up and said, "Coach, we've got to have better yardage for this guy. He's number 9 in the league. He's got to be in the top 3 before the season's over. Let's run the ball."
3 yards on that last carry. Here's 2nd and 7. He's going to try and take off with it, and he'll lose yardage here, going down back at the 28. Now they're going to be dealing with a 3rd and 7. Is that one officially a loss of 1? Well, that play never really got off the launching pad. He had a linebacker in his face before he had a chance to do much of anything.
Yeah, I think his big boys up front, that offensive line, they've got to do a little bit better job.
And he'll be brought down by the Colts. Quiddy Pay brings him down, and that's a play he's... Play action. They'll throw toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a 1st down. Well done.
Good job there getting his tight end involved, because he lines up on the right side of the formation, just works his way across the field. I really like how they were in sync on that one. He spotted the open gap in the zone, and his quarterback found him, and they get a 1st down.
On 1st down, it's Henry. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. DeForest Buckner, all-pro defensive tackle there on the stop. And Charles, we get a look here at the key inactives, and I tell you what, a big list for being this early in the season.
If there's any silver lining at all, you're hoping you can get these guys back, and now you'll play well down the stretch with them. But what you're also hoping is that the guys who have to play for them, the next man up mentality kicks in, and those guys take care of business.
Give him 9 yards on the scramble there, but it does leave him still a few inches shy with 3rd down looming. They'll try to run for the 1st with Henry. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
And Derrick Henry with the ball in his hands, what a sight to behold, because power and speed. Involved in every touch for him. Coming off another spectacular season with the Titans, he became the 1st since LaDainian Tomlinson in 2006 and 2007 to win 2 straight rushing titles. And he did it with style, too. Just the 8th man to top 2,000 yards and the 1st since Adrian Peterson in 2012. He has his sights set on another 2,000-yard season.
Complete to Jones. And they got it inside the 10 at the 8.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
He'll drop to throw. And it's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Des Fitzpatrick with his first... Try and start this drive in the air. And a high throw there as this is knocked away, down to the ground and incomplete. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Again to Henry. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. And for the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on third down. They'll look to throw here. Escaping the pressure right. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
That's something you have to be aware of as a defense and have to find a way to account for him. And if you're not going to use a spy, you're telling your guys to keep your eyes on him, because when he breaks out and makes plays like that, all he does is hurt you.
Have to at least be able to contain him somewhat. There they could not. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Next receivers have spread the defense out, and they were able to come through with a slashing run.
But to that point, it's going to be interesting to see the personnel chess match as this one progresses.
Yeah, you're exactly right. Can they continue to create running lanes out of passing sets? And if so, it's going to be a long day for the defense.
Second and 3. Oh, ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off by Kenny Moore, and the Colts will take over here as they get it up to the 43-yard line. So problems with errant passing continue. They'll run on first down. Henry takes to midfield, but no further. Just a yard there.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes. They'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. He'll look to throw. He's going to float this over the middle, deep. And is this intercepted? It is. It's intercepted. Picked off by Kenny Moore. And the Colts are going to take possession here. Shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And the return out shy of midfield to the 46-yard line. Start with the option. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. On first down, it's Henry. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down.
with the end of all that hitting and hollering. It was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle, feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run. But the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Now a timeout being called as there's an injured Titan down on the field.
The Titans on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 8.
While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down.
That was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice gain.
And he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field.
The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6.
While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside.
And he's going to get this pretty close to a first down at the Colts 31.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
On third down, Henry. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Flush to his right. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be 2nd down.
Now that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable 2nd and short.
2nd and 4.
Got a man, and it's taken in for a Titans touchdown.
Racy McMahon.
His first NFL reception goes for 6. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this. They'll look to throw here on first down.
That's caught by McMahon.
And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Back to throw now on first down. And his pass is intercepted for the 4th time today. Picked off by Rocky Sin. And the Colts are going to take over a couple of yards shy of midfield. Back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. Eluding the pressure right. And they work this well upfield across the 45. Now Tennessee going to use the 2nd of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. He'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Here's 2nd and 10.
Back to throw here. Man open here is Jones. And they'll get him to the ground. He has another first down at the Colts 33. They'll set up to throw. He's going to air one out. And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up 2nd down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Oh, that was
sailed a bit, but the catch is still made. First down now, but the clock continues to move. They'll set up a throw. Dancing to his left. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's second down. They're going to look to throw. Caught on the slant. They'll run on first down. Henry, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. 53 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Derrick Henry, and he'll power his way forward for about 4 yards there on the first down carry.
Well, on every play call, you realize it's not going to go for a touchdown, so a lot of your calls are setting things up for maybe later in the game, trying to establish the inside run, run with toughness now, hopefully get to the perimeter later. Let's face it.
That's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tennessee. Anthony Furkser, his second touchdown on the season, and the Titans are just an extra point away from moving out. They'll start by running the option to the right. He gets away from one. He'll get 8 on the keeper there. It'll be second and a couple.
Well, that's what he can do, you know, when he keeps the football. It's not a huge gain, but it shows how hard it can be to stop him.
Yeah, and I thought the defense had that one pretty well contained. And, in fact, they probably came up and felt pretty good about what they did. Then they looked up and realized he still got good yardage out of it. He's a tough guy to stop.
Now this throw caught left side. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. A big connection on that one. 35 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Looking to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back.
Second and 7, operating from the 34.
Henry out of the pistol. And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. And when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day. And that's well executed there on third down, and I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
Now the result here, a pickup of 8, leaves them with 2 to go on second down.
Some good strong running right there, some power and some explosiveness just about got them into the end zone.
Second down, they go again with Henry. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. Seventh play of the drive now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. They'll drop the throw. We'll check on him. And it's a Titans touchdown! Des Fitzpatrick, his second touchdown of the afternoon. To start the drive. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. Now back to throw. First down and much more here for Jones. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line.
Tell you what, a lot of those mid-range throws have been available because sometimes teams get too concerned about the deep ball and they leave too much space in front of them, and these guys have been taking advantage so far.
And they run the option here on first and 10, and he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It looked like almost a miscommunication defensively, because once he decided to keep it, he had pretty smooth sailing.
Yeah, it became a question of, wait a minute, who's got the quarterback? And when you talk about miscommunication, it's supposed to be called assignment football on the defensive side of the ball, but the assignment gets mixed up, that's the end result.
Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 36. They'll run it here. This is Deontay Foreman. Pretty nice aggressive run there before being brought down just inside of the 30. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave it with a second and 3. Going for it all. And that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play of the third quarter. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we played three quarters. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. And he will be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Carry for Foreman, and this will be a gain of 6 when it's all said and done, down to the 15 from the 21. This drive's taken more than 3 minutes off the clock already as they come up on second down. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he will score! Touchdown, Titans! Touchdown run, and the Titans are going to add on. The drive starts with Foreman on the ground, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. DeForest Buckner using that size to force his way in there and make the stop behind the line. Second and 13. Escaping the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And this is caught right along the sideline. What a job of keeping the toes in bounds there. A big play that time for the Titans.
We see this happen so often. If you're a defender, it's like watching a bad movie over and over. The pressure is good, forcing the quarterback out of the pocket. But it's a lot to ask for these defenders to stay plastered to receivers long enough. And sure enough, they let a man come open, and the connection leads to a big play.
The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. He'll wind up losing a full 9 yards here on the sack. Now it's third down. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The cover. And they'll begin by running the option. And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it, but it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there by the quarterback.
The last run got six, now second and four. Now Foreman, and 3 yards there, takes him to the 45.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. And he will have a Titans first down. At least it would appear that way. He didn't get it by much, but yes, they do get the conversion on third and one. Couple of first downs to kick off the drive. Here's first and 10 up at the 46. They run on first down, but it only produces a gain of 2. It's second down now.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. They'll get this complete to Fitzpatrick. They'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20.
These guys are running offense like you drive. The pedal is down, stomp down. How about that? Back-to-back completions, they are rolling.
So much for being conservative and running that football. And he will be brought down at about the 6-yard line.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
Yep.
And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. A great play there. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. Defense still with 3 timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on offense?
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving.
Walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we was sliding in that Ford door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came on them. I do my own stunts, don't need a backup. Tired of feeling broke, I got my racks up. These 4 pockets full won't fold on me. Remember we was sliding in that Ford door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one. I was walking down a dark road, hard cold, all alone. I'm on
on my own, nobody better ask me for none. Remember we were sliding in that four-door Audi. When it smoke, they get the hot and make them scary boys run. Remember when I ain't have it, if I want it, I can buy it. I ain't bragging, I can go and blow it back just for fun. If we gon' keep it real, I took a lot of L's. I know pain, I went through hell, but I still came out number one.